Alright. But. Okay, come on. But the end of all things at hand, be ye therefore sober and watch under prayer. So that word sober right there, that's in connection with coming out of the sin. Right? Coming out of the sin. Sober. You know? Telling our brother we can. Telling our brother about the sin. Sober. Alright? To be drunk is to be participating in the conversation of the sin, telling each other we can love our neighbors as ourselves, karma, what goes around comes around, the golden rule, do unto others we have them do unto us, the secret, law of attraction, co-creating our own reality, Lester Crowley philosophies, do what thou wilt, the hold the law, you know. Anybody that thinks that they can perform such things as a philosophy of life and that they're going to get their eternal life based on that philosophy, living that thing, that's all philosophy that comes from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil that Satan planted. Okay, above all things, have fervent love among yourselves, and love cover a multitude of sins. Multitude of sins. So we know that that includes the sin and our sin nature that we do, because we're always going to have our sin nature. We're always going to be doing bad things here and there, you know. Even though we're walking in the truth, we can call our brother a dumbass one day. So you dumbass, pull your head out of your butt. What the heck are you doing? but realize that, you know, we're all okay. Use hospitality one another without grudging. So here we can see that, you know, it seems like he's talking about the sin nature now. So there's a fine line, a delicate balance of where he's going in and out of the sin and the sin nature. That's what I'm starting to find out. So, as every man hath received the gift, even so minister the same one to another, good stewards in the manifold wisdom of grace. Okay, now okay, so it's received the gift. So. If any man speak, let him speak of the oracles of the Most High. If any man, let a minister do so of the ability of what the Most High have giveth, that Most High all things may be glorified through Yeshua, to whom praise, dominion. Now keep in mind here, this is the early church, and there were gifts given to the early church to help them to come to the fullness of the truth. And each man would have his, the Holy Spirit would show him insights and different things about the truth. And they would speak it to the truth, and they would build each other by speaking all this stuff together. Okay, so, and then the gift ceased. After everybody was mature, the gift ceased. There were no need for gifts. Everything was explained. Everybody knew. So the gift ceased, right? And therefore the congregations would cease too. The gatherings together would cease. They would just walk about and go throughout their lives now. So think about that. Think about that. And we learn about the gifts that are ceasing in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Paul tells us all about the gifts that are ceasing. That will cease. Beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial that is to try you as though some strange thing happened to you, but rejoice in as much that you are partakers of the Most High suffering, that when His glory shall be revealed, you may be glad also with exceeding joy. So yeah, they're being persecuted. He's talking about their persecutions as the early church. They're going around saying, hey, we're not under the law of Moses no more. And they're like, oh yes you are, you dumb. And so they persecute them. Right? And some of them wouldn't even like him so much as to go out and put him in prison and jail and kill him and all everything else. So that's why he says stuff like, you know, be nice. In other words, honor the king. You know, honor your bosses. You know, you start telling your boss about the gospel story and he's like, gives you an extra 4 hours of overtime. And if you don't do it, he'll fire you. Threaten to fire you and all that other good stuff. So be on your best guard, you know. Because, you know, for the most part, you know, when people see that you're on your best guard, you know, and that you're truly and, you know, genuinely wanting to be nice to them, and, you know, and then they can sense that. And it's only through being nice to them that they really want to hear. They really will even give any ear to what you have to say, right? Because if you be, you know, mean to them and stuff like that, they ain't want to hear what you have to say. So there's a benefit right there for being nice. You know, You know, basically the gist of Paul's message is you can do whatever you want now that you're not under the law. He says, but be nice. Because why? Because there's a benefit to being nice. People are open to listening to what the gospel is when you're nice to them. So, even if they mistreat you, you still be nice to them. They're like, you know, hey man, just that ear still probably be there. If ye be reproached for the name of the Most High, happy are ye, for the Spirit of the glory and the Most High resteth on you, and on their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, as a busybody, or in other men's manners. Yet if any of you suffer as an acceptor of the truth, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify the Most High on this behalf. For the time is come that judgment shall begin at the house of the Most High. And if it begins first at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of the Most High? And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the untruthly and the sinner appear? Wherefore let them that suffer according to the will of the Most High commit the keeping of their souls to him in well doing as unto a faithful creator. Okay, so go on to the next chapter. Okay, chapter 5. The elders that are among you I exhort, who I am an elder and a witness of the suffering of the anointed, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of the Most High that is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly. See there, there's another word there, willingly. Not a filthy lucre, but a ready mind. Neither is being lords over the Most High's heritage, but being an example of the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder, yea, and be subject to one another, and be clothed with humility, for the Most High resist the proud, and give grace unto the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High, and he may exalt you in due time, casting your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, roaring like a lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are clumps in your brethren that are in the world. But the Most High of all grace, who hath called us unto the eternal glory in Yeshua, the Anointed, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, and strengthen you. Look at that. After ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, and strengthen you. So, how about that? And that could also be said for the resisting the temptation of the former conversation, telling each other we can love our neighbors as ourselves, as well as, you know, people talking down to us and stuff like that. You know, after a while we get a thick skin and it doesn't bother us anymore. So, to him be the glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. By Severinus, our faithful brother, unto you, as I suppose I have written briefly, exhorting and testifying that this is true grace of the Most High, wherein ye stand. The church of the Babylonian elect is another, saluteth you, and Marcus my son. Greet one another with a holy kiss and love. Peace be with you all in Yeshua the Anointed. Amen. So that's the end of that book. So how about that? So we'll wait till I get more motivation and energy, and we'll probably do some more. So that's enough for now.